Welcome back to our Intermediate Financial Accounting class. Over the last few segments, we've been talking about the income statement, what it is, why it's important, and how to build one. We talked about how to create a multi-step income statement. We looked at some other versions under US GAAP and IFRS, and then we started talking about the unusual line items and transactions that sometimes have to be recorded, and that really can change significantly how our income statement appears. In this segment, we get to continue on with that discussion, introducing now the two adjustments that go below the line, income from continuing operations. And we're going to start with this one, discontinued operations. Now, in order to count as a discontinued operation, you have to be completely getting out of a line of business. You can't just be tweaking it or changing it. You can't be dropping one subsidiary that does that particular business but still have three others. You can't be switching countries. You have to be completely getting out of the line of business. If you still are in that line at all, it doesn't count as a discontinued operation. So we have to be really careful in answering a question like this first to decide, is this really a discontinued operation? Do we really get to count it that way? And to help us kind of get a feel of this, I've got some examples that I want to run through that I hope will help us solidify this idea. So let's take a look at this first one. This is a meatpacking company. They've also managed a shopping mall for the last 15 years. And they've decided now, you know, we're meatpacking. This really doesn't make any sense. We're going to sell it off and get rid of it. Well, since everything else this company does is in meatpacking, and they have nothing else in shopping malls, then selling off the shopping mall line would be a discontinued operation. I have completely left that line of business. Everything I do now is meatpacking. What about this one? Sale of a foreign subsidiary engaged in silver mining by a mining company. The sale includes all the company's activities in that country, but they still have other silver mines in other places. This would not count as a discontinued operation. Just moving countries or dropping a country doesn't mean I'm out of that line of business. It just means that for various political or other reasons, I've decided not to do business in that country anymore. So if I sold off this mine, I would have to show that gain or loss on the sale up above the line with my other gains and losses, rent revenue, etc. in the gains and losses section. Third, a communications company sold all of its radio stations, but they still have three television stations and a publishing company. This one might be a little bit more challenging because in looking at this, you say, well, they're still in communications, so no, maybe it isn't a discontinued operation. This one actually is a discontinued operation, although some people may argue, well, wait a minute, I'm still in communications. Just because I've dropped that one line, I still am doing about the same thing. Well, the truth is you're not really doing the same thing. You're offering three different services here that are completely unique. This gives me a great opportunity to provide you with a specific rule of thumb that you can use. Now, you can't take it to an extreme. It's a rule of thumb. It's meant to be a shortcut, not substitute for thought, okay? But the idea here is if I can take the equipment from the business I'm dropping or discontinuing and use it in my other businesses or my other subsidiaries or in my main business, it's not a discontinued operation. So if we go back to that second example with the mining company, if I sell off my line in or my mine in Argentina, I could take all of that mining equipment to Ecuador or Mexico or Canada or wherever I've got my silver mine, and I could use it all there. So it's not a discontinued operation. I'm still a mining company, and I use the same stuff. Now take a look at that first example that we said was a discontinued operation. Let's see. Could I take the equipment I used to manage the mall and use it to pack meat? Probably not. Now, this is where, don't go too far, right? You could say, well, you could take the seeds and use them in your production company. Yeah, right. You could certainly MacGyver some kind of use of these assets and continue to use them. But this is just a rule of thumb. In this case, could I take the microphones and recording equipment from a radio station and use them in television or publishing? No. Why? Because I have to have totally separate microphones and video cameras and other equipment to record movies and videos and TV shows than I do to record a radio broadcast. And I certainly wouldn't use the microphones and other equipment in a publishing house. So this would be a discontinued operation. Let's take a look at another one. A well-diversified company sells off one of its two furniture-making subsidiaries. Nope, definitely not, because I have another subsidiary that does exactly the same thing, so not a discontinued operation. Sale of a factory making wool suits so they can do synthetics. Nope, not a discontinued operation. Just because I've changed the input doesn't mean the business itself has changed. I've just changed the way I do that business. So that's not a discontinued operation. Food distributor disposes of one of its two divisions. That division sells wholesale. The other sells to fast food restaurants. Is this one discontinued? The answer is no. I'm still distributing food. It's just to a different group. So chances are this one is not a discontinued operation. Of all of them, this is the most debatable. Why? Because you could argue that, hey, I sell completed prepared foods to the restaurants. They just reheat them and sell them, as opposed to I sell raw food and produce and stuff to supermarkets. Maybe that is a discontinued operation because I would no longer use the food preparation equipment just to sell raw materials to other stores. So probably not, but this one you might be able to get away with if you really wanted to. It would depend on your auditor and how the SEC was feeling at the time. Let's go back and see then if CBDS's example qualifies as a discontinued operation. In this case, they've been running a shipping business and they're going to sell that off to FedEx so that they can concentrate on manufacturing. Discontinued? Yeah, probably. Because it really would not be a good fit to take shipping equipment, delivery trucks or planes or whatever I'm using, and try to use them in a production facility. I might be able to stretch it and use it to haul stuff back and forth, but really, this is a discontinued operation. Whew. Means we get to do this example. All right, we're going to come back in the next segment, and we're going to talk about how you actually do this in the income statement. We'll see you then.